Hello guys, welcome back to Clutch X. Like always, I'm Zo. I can't really change my name, so I don't know why I keep saying it. But we're gonna jump into the video. In today's video, we're gonna talk about the five things that I would ask before buying a ball python. I have to say, I'm guilty of not following my own advice now. And I wish I would have known that when purchasing this ball python. So please stay tuned so you can see what we're talking about. Okay guys, so the first thing we're gonna talk about, and that for me, the most important questions to ask, so I'm gonna give you the five top for me, but obviously you guys may differ, so please comment below or the additional questions that you may ask your, you know, the potential person you buy a ball python from. So, you know, these will be my first two. For me, it's the sex. Now, you might say, oh, but it's online. There's no way that, you know, they're gonna get it wrong once they put it up on the internet or wherever you buy it from. Well, let me tell you, recently at the Pomona show, I was trying to buy the Enchi Pastel Pinstripe Pied male, and he was actually giving me a female, which would have been a lot more expensive, obviously, because it was a female. She was about 1,400 grams. So almost ready to breed, so that would have been, you know, it would have sucked for the guy, right? So I actually, for my own benefit, asked him to sex it on the spot, and when he did, he realized that he was getting me the female, not the male. So sometimes I would say that if you're asking to, you know, the person you're purchasing from, the sex of the snake, he might actually go back and double check just to be sure, right? So the first thing that I would ask is the sex. The second thing that I would ask is the age. It's always important to know what age the ball python is, because then it could give you clues on, you know, its size, you know, why are they sending it, if it's a grow slower, a fast grower, and kind of get more information about the snakes in general. Okay, so the third and fourth thing that I would ask is the weight. Now, this weight question is kind of related with the age question, right? You kind of want to see, you know, they go hand in hand, because what you want to, when I do is when I determine if I'm going to purchase a snake, is if it's a finicky eater, if it's a fast grower or a slow grower. So sometimes that's important, because if you have a 2016 ball python and it's only 600 grams, you know, it's kind of three years old, then you know that that snake's either been malnourished or is very finicky or just isn't a good eater. So, you know, that kind of gives you a clue, and then you can make the call whether to take on that project for yourself and maybe even inherit those problems, right? If it is just a finicky eater or a poor eater or anything like that. Not really the breeder's fault, right? You know, ball pythons are notorious for not eating. So, you know, kind of that's one of the main questions I would also ask. And the other thing I would ask is diet. You know, before actually thinking, you know, when I first started, I would never ask what they were feeding on, right? So then sometimes you could get, you could get them on frozen thawed, you get them on just freshly killed, you get rats, you could get mice, you know, maybe smaller mice, bigger rats, you just don't know. So it's always good to ask that question so you make sure that you're ready and you have the food source to feed your new ball python before it gets to your home. Okay guys, so the fifth thing I would ask is the genes. I would ask a breeder to verify the genes to make sure that I'm not misreading anything and that I'm not interpreting anything differently, to make sure that I'm going to be happy with my purchase and not, you know, by my fault or his fault or anybody's fault, you know, be confused and not be as satisfied as I would if I knew what the actual genes were. And for the sixth and final bonus thing to ask, for me personally, something that I learned the hard way, and it has to do with this ball python here. As you can see here, it's a beautiful snake, but the wobble on her is very severe compared to my other spider gene combo females. So this is something that I wish I knew, and that's a perfect example there. You see the way she's moving? You know, some people don't mind it. I do. I think that with, you know, selective breeding, we could definitely reduce this to a degree where it's 99% normal and it has just an occasional wobble. In this case, this girl here, even though she's really, really pretty, growing really, really fast and healthy, I kind of feel bad. I feel bad that it has such a severe wobble. And the breeder never mentioned it to me. It's not his fault. I never asked. But after purchasing this female, every time I'm gonna purchase a spider-related gene animal, I always ask if the wobble is there and if it's severe, because sometimes You know, personally for me, if I produce animals like this, I don't think I would ever sell them because the wobble is very severe. And I think with selective breeding, we can get rid of this problem. And it's just the fact that people don't take the time to do that. And that's why we continue to have these issues, right? And I think it's the same thing with like Super Cinnamon or Caramel Albinos, where, you know, they could be have kinking. So there's other genes that could actually have deformities as well. So you have to be aware of what animals carry those kind of like deformities and ask before you purchase those animals. So there you guys have it. Like always, if you like our videos, please consider subscribing. You saw my list. If you have a list that differs from mine, comment down below, let us know. Because, you know, there's, I'm assuming there's hundreds of questions that we could ask before buying a snake, right? So please comment below, and hope we see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.